Welcome to the video. Usually is Leila Nishmas Shmo Baruch Mechayim Tzvidor. That's our daily video, and dedicated by a very special Mishpacha Salman and Mishpacha. Today, special dedication for an incredible neshama, a neshama of a 24-year-old boy, a tzaddik in our times, Chaim Doy Ben Risa Shoshana Ben Tzion Shalom, a Talmud, a friend, a Rebbe probably to Klal Yisrael, and I'll explain, and we'll connect this video to yesterday's Shaila that we left off. So starting first with the Shaila, we asked the question, where did the gold come from? And it's amazing. You ask most people, and they'll tell you, what do you mean it came from the women? So we left off with the question, what do you mean? But the women didn't give their jewelry to, they didn't want to give jewelry to the, for the building of the Egel Azov. So one answer we said is, yeah, they grabbed it off the women. Now it doesn't say that, doesn't seem to say that anywhere. And what's interesting is, as I pointed out, it's quite painful. So that, Behashgacha, my wife was wearing certain earrings, and she said, you know, these types of earrings you could just pull off. So it could be that that's definitely one of the pshats, and there's no doubt the people, we've been taught that the men grab the jewelry off the women. But there's another simple pshat. And what's so interesting about this pshat, some in Baruch Hashem, some of you actually were mechavim to this pshat, but it's a Rashi. Rashi says, and if you look very carefully, Rashi says on the word vayisporaku, Rashi says the lashon v'ispar. He goes to what's called dikduk. Dikduk is understanding how the Hebrew language, the lashon hakodesh language, works. And the joke is, or the unfortunate joke is, that a third about of Rashi's is dikduk, is about how to understand the conjugation of words, because it makes such a difference. Perhaps this is one of the biggest differences. Rashi goes on to explain that if you look carefully at the words, Rashi tells us that vayisporaku yispael means it's reflexive. Mishel atzmon, they took of their own. What does that mean? So Rav Schwab explains, but it's really based on a Pirkei Rabbi Eliezer, that the men were wearing a certain type of earring. And when they saw that the women are not giving it, instead of learning the lesson from the women, instead of learning Yira Shamayim, instead of learning what it means to have an earring, they took their own earrings and they used their earrings for the gold. That's what Rashi tells us. And amazing. And Rav Schwab explains it so beautifully. And this is a message that I thought would be so powerful. Why are men wearing earrings? So it could be just the style of those days. Like I pointed out, this is based on styles. And today maybe it's coming the norm. But there was something so much deeper. And as I pointed out, there was no nose rings involved. Why? Because the idea of a ring was supposed to ring in our heads and in our ears and in our minds, the idea that the Rabbeinu Shel Olam said, Avodai, you're my slaves. And that's what there's an issue to be to be sold as a slave, because you're my servant. I took you as a servant. When I was in Mitzrayim, I told you that this is what's going to get you out of Mitzrayim. You know how? If you serve me on this mountain, you're going to be my true servant. Oh, and what a true servant means is Moshe Rabbeinu was called Avdi. He was an Eved Neman, because it's not a slave that just wants to do, has to do something, because otherwise it's going to get whacked, or it's going to get smacked, or it's not going to get its paycheck. And this real servant is higher even than a ben, than a son. And that was Moshe Rabbeinu. And in our times, we had a boy. His name was Dov, Chaim Dov. Dovi, as he was known affectionately, was a kid, was a boy for his entire life, searching for the truth, searching to find out what the Rebbe really wants. At the Levaya, if there was one point, one theme, that it was so clear, this boy walked around, and he was a genius, he was a smart boy, he was a Talmud Chacham, he was an incredible brother, but there was something about his search for truth. What does Hashem really want? He had the hardest times of the, I remember myself, he would ask me, Ashali, if I didn't have it so clear. His neshama was so clear. He went through four medurah again, literally the four different meters of based, and his skin would burnt. He couldn't breathe for 2 years. The yisurim that he went is unimaginable. And it was, there's no doubt, mechapel for thousands of neshamas besides his own neshama. What's amazing is that there was a group that was learning every single day. My wife was part of this group that was reading from Living Emunah. And yesterday's reading was all about the asifa that took place of neshamas regarding the last stage before Mashiach comes. And part of it was the conclusion was, and this is brought down already in the Arizal, that there are certain neshamas that needed a tikkun, and the tikkun that they needed was to come down into this world for a certain amount of years, and that's why before Mashiach comes, there's going to be people that are going to be dying early. And that early death is neshamas. Again, this is straight from the Arizal. So you just have to have emunah that the Rebbeinu Shem runs the world. They're going to be in this world and they're going to be so pure. Be'etzen, they're going to be misakin, things are going to go through you soon. And you're going to ask, and we're going to ask, why? It's going to be so much higher than what we understand. And this guy, this Chaim Dov, if there was one thing they represented was this earring. So we don't wear earrings today, not necessarily. And if someone did, I wouldn't think he's so crazy either, but I'm not recommending it. The best thing is to wear a spiritual earring and to ask the Rebbeinu Shlom, and then Le'ilu Nishmas, Chaim Dov, is that when something happens in my life, when someone's speaking to me, when I have a choice, should I do, should I not do? Someone's saying Lashon Hara in the room. My ears should ring and say, ding, ding, ding. Rebbeinu Shlom says this is not the right thing. I'm so sorry, I can't do this. Le'ilu Nishmas Chaim Dov, I can't do this. He was in the search for truth. Yehi zichro baruch. Hatzlacha.